Basically, I would like to thank Pathak sir for giving us this opportunity to develop such an project. And we learned a lot in this project about developing and work ethic and working in a team. So I'd like to introduce my teammates, Pooja, Archana, then Sonu, Prathamesh, Sudhanshu, Pratik, and Prashant. So our project was basically to get a product designed, optical assembly designed, in order to scan. So our project was basically to design a fingerprint optical assembly. What currently is being done using the Aakash tablet is that they are using an Aakash tablet for Aadhar authentication purpose. They are taking a fingerprint, and using that fingerprint they are able to tell the if the person whose fingerprint is there, his Aadhar ID matches with that or not. So what they currently are using, they are connecting an OTG cable. With that they are connecting a Futronic Tech device. They are connecting that device to that Aakash table and then scanning the fingerprint using that device. What we have done in this project is we have designed our own optical assembly, modified some softwares and developed some softwares, and we are scanning this fingerprint on our own software, optical assembly, and we are using this optical assembly for this authentication purpose. The previous assembly was costing something like 4000 rupees. Our current assembly is on approximate cost of 180 rupees. But with some more modification, I think it will be a little more costly than it is currently present. So I'd like Sudhanshu to continue.
Hello, I am Sudhanshu Verma from NIT Nagpur, and I was working on the optical assembly of this project. So the optical assembly, we have just we are using the Aakash tablet's camera itself to capture the image for authentication of Aadhar card users. So this is our optical assembly. Our optical assembly consists of three parts. The first part is the clamp. So clamp just is used for making the optical assembly stable on the tablet this way, and it also there is a support for the spacer. Our spacer is to make a definite distance between the fingerprint impression and the camera of the Aakash tablet. So we have used a spacer for that thing. Third part is the optical part. In which we have used acrylic, and on the sides of the acrylic we have used LEDs. So we have put LEDs on the sides of the acrylic such that it illuminates the acrylic perfectly by the concept of a total internal reflection. And we have used components like black acrylic to cover the whole setup such that no outside light interferes with our fingerprint impression. And transparent sheet of acrylic for getting the fingerprint impression, and we have used LEDs and given up a 4.5 volt power source to these LEDs. And next is the FTIR principle, how we are getting the difference between the ridges and valleys of our fingers. So FTIR principles works in such a way that the whole of the acrylic is illuminated due to total internal reflection. So FTIR principle is frustrated total internal reflection, in which the light travels due to total internal reflection it travels in the whole of the acrylic. So wherever the ridges touch the acrylic, the light gets absorbed, and hence we are able to get RGB image there, and the parts where valleys are there, they are little bit up than this acrylic, so they are in the air, so they get scattered, due to which we get a white part, white patch there. So this is it, and now Pooja will continue.
Hello everyone, I am Pooja Dev from NIT Nagpur. So after the image is captured, it goes through a series of processing. Initially, as my friend Sudhanshu explained, the image gets captured. After it is captured, it is grayscale. What grayscaling does is the RGB image that gets converted into a gray image. After that, the image gets cropped so that the background is removed and only the fingerprint gets processed. After that, the image is resized to get a clearer image. After resizing, adaptive histogram equalization is done. In adaptive histogram equalization, the contrast is spread out so that the clarity of the image is increased. After that, sharpening is done. Image sharpening basically brings out the ridges in the fingerprint. So after sharpening, thresholding is done. Right now, you have a grayscaled image that gets turned into a binarized image. A binarized image is an image which is white pixels and black pixels. After that, thinning is done so that the thick ridges, those get converted into a pixel thickness. And finally, the enhanced binarized image that is sent over to the server for authentication. So this is the basic workflow. And live finger detection, this is one technique that basically detects if the finger is of a live person or it is a spoof. So the fingerprint scanner that can be fooled by using a gelatin fingerprint or a silicone fingerprint. So what this problem can be solved by using hardware or software. So right now my friend Prathamesh, he implemented the live finger detection. So he used a software approach. Basically it makes use of pore detection and perspiration. When you place the fingerprint on the scanner, due to perspiration the grayscale of the image changes. And this change in grayscale determines whether the finger is of a live person or no. But unfortunately, it requires a very high resolution camera, and the camera of Aakash is providing to be a bit of a problem. So we've been unable to implement it in our model. So I'll tell Archana to continue.
My name is Archana, and I'm going to be talking about the next step in our algorithm. So first, what we do is adaptive histogram equalization. So in this step, what you do is you increase the contrast of the image. Now by doing this, you can easily differentiate between the ridges and the valleys more clearly. So what is done is you take the histogram of the image and you spread out the values such that the high intensity values are made even higher and the lower ones are made even lower. So the basic algorithm is first to compute the histogram of the images by checking the intensity values and checking their frequency. After that, you calculate the CDF, which is the cumulative density function, and then you find that of the histogram. And that is the transformation function, which is used to transform the input pixels to the output pixels. And this is the image that we took from the Aakash tablet. And before we apply the contrast, before the contrast is increased, that's the image, where you can see that the histogram is not very equalized and it has peaks. So what we do is we stretch out the histogram so that the contrast increases. And after we do histogram equalization, what we do is we do image thresholding. So thresholding is used to convert a grayscale image into a black and white binary image. So so the algorithm that we followed is Otsu's algorithm. So in this, first what you do is you make the histogram and you find out the probabilities of each intensity level. After that, for each to find the threshold value, you take each intensity and you find its weight, its mean, its variance, and within class variance. And whichever intensity value gives you the minimum within class variance, that is chosen to be the threshold value. So when we applied Otsu's algorithm, before thresholding, this was our grayscale image. And you can see that the values on the histogram vary on the grayscale. And after applying thresholding, we get a binarized black and white image with the values only pure black and pure white. Sonu is going to explain the next.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'll be talking about image sharpening. So when we sharpen an image, what happens is we enhance the details of the image. So details of the image that was not visible to the eye before, they become clear after you sharpen the image. So features like the hair strands or the facial features, they become much clearer. Now when you sharpen a fingerprint, what happens is the ridges, they become more clearer, so you can identify the ridges in the fingerprint. So the algorithm that we use is, we have used Laplacian kernel-based convolution. Laplacian kernel is a standard matrix that is used for sharpening. So first we take the input image and then we apply the convolution to it and then we get the sharpened image. So over here we can see before sharpening the ridges aren't very clear in the fingerprint, but after sharpening you can easily identify the ridges. And also in the histogram we can see that after sharpening histogram is a little more distributed. That is like more pixels are given more importance and more pixels you show the details of more pixels. Next, I'll talk about image thinning. In image thinning, what we do is we reduce the thickness of the image, that is by reducing the number of pixels in the image. Now, this is done because a thinned image, it occupies a lesser amount of memory, and it is also easier to process a thinned image because it contains only very few pixels. Now, when we, our thinning, when we thin the fingerprint, what we do is we reduce the thickness of the ridges to 1 pixel thickness. Now, this is done because it is easier to extract details like minutiae points from a thinned ridge, and these minutiae points, they are used for fingerprint recognition and matching, etc. So in the picture, we can see this is the original input image, and after thinning, we get a 1 pixel thickness ridges. Now I'll call Pooja to talk about the future scope.
So firstly, the optical assembly, it can be enhanced by using infrared LEDs or assembly LEDs. Secondly, various techniques like use of polarizing filters and macro lenses can be used to obtain a better image of the fingerprint. Apart from that, the problem we faced was that we could not send the image to the server because we did not have access. So authentication using the enhanced image could not be done. So that can be implemented in future. So the problems we faced during the making of this assembly were, firstly, finding the distance at which the image is focused and is clear. For that, the viewing angle of the camera was calculated, and the focal length was calculated by doing various experiments. The second problem we faced was, initially we were planning to use a glass sheet for capturing the image. However, glass sheet has a green tint, which affected the quality of the image. For that, we replaced glass by an acrylic sheet. The third was illumination in an acrylic sheet. The light, it wasn't being distributed properly. To solve this problem, a number of LEDs were used, and the number of LEDs being used, they were varied. And finally, an optimum number, 4, was calculated. The fourth problem we faced was deciding the workflow of the image enhancement process. As I explained earlier, the image goes through a number of processing algorithms. So to solve this problem, we first made use of Scilab. Using different permutations, we decided which process gives the most optimum result. And finally, the process as shown was decided. And fifth was implementing it on Aakash tablet. For that, we used OpenCV. OpenCV is an open source software, and it has a dedicated platform for Android. So we developed the code using OpenCV and then finally implemented it on Aakash tablet. So the things we learned in this project were basically image processing using OpenCV. Secondly, we learned using Scilab. Scilab, as I mentioned earlier, is also an open source software. It was the first time we were studying image processing, and we studied several algorithms to do the same. The fourth thing, we learned Android application development. Creating an hardware assembly, we faced, as explained before, certain problems were faced, and we learned to overcome them. And finally, we learned how to document a project. Like, we made the SRS, the SDD, and the project report. So, yeah. And apart from the project, we had a side project. So, some Android applications were made. This is an Aakash dictionary. This is an application that provides formulas and in algebra and geometry. The third is, this gives history of India. Then the fourth was plotting graphs. The fifth was Incredible India. It gives information about various states in India. The sixth is periodic table. It gives information about the various elements. The seventh is consumer protection, the various rules for consumer protection. The eighth is salt analysis. So on a concluding note, I would like to thank Fatak sir for providing us with this wonderful opportunity to work on Aadhar authentication. I would also like to thank Karma and Agesh sir for guiding us throughout the process. I would like to thank Prakash sir and Naresh sir for helping us build the optical assembly. And I would also like to thank our mentors who guided us through all sticky spots. And last but not the least, I would like to thank all my team members for contributing so much to the project. And finally, we would like to show a demonstration of our application.
The first image is the standard image of finger that we took from 3 megapixel camera. It's showing it clearly shows the better result than the image we are going to took from this VGA camera. You have to just scan. We have to show the demo on this one. This is the result by the VJ camera on Aakash tablet. This we are developed using the different techniques, using thinning, thresholding.
One question is, have you actually tried this application against the Aadhar server?
No, sir.
Why? But I had specifically said, where is Rajesh? Who are the mentors?
They had a problem, actually.
No. The idea was that even if they get a rejection, the fact that end-to-end application is built can be proven only after you connect to Aadhar. So why was that not done?
So they had approached, sir, and they could not get the link, sir, proper link.
Sir, we were not able to contact the guy who is there at testing server.
In the Affordable Solutions Lab. Anybody from ASL here?
Sir, we met. Sir, we met Rajesh sir, but he was not able to contact.
Sir, because we have to open up the test server to check it against the database. But the person who had opened it up earlier for testing, he wasn't available. So.
At the other end.
Yeah, at the other end. We weren't able to cross-check with him directly. We tried finding different links, but we weren't able to access it.
Because even if with this camera it didn't work, you have made the same application run on any other Android tablet, right?
Yes.
And you have tested that there you get much better clarity.
Yes.
Now, do you have a suggestion on the specification of the camera resolution?
Sir, actually the camera resolution is important, but what is more important is that the finger should be focused upon.
Yeah.
So in that, for doing that, we had ordered some lenses, but by the time they arrived, it was too late for us to implement.
The lenses.
Yes, we have ordered some lenses.
So whom have you transferred this technology so that the work can be continued further?
We have mentioned in the reports further.
The report is, who is the person here who has read your report? If he has not read it now, it's unlikely that he will read it over the next 2 months. What about your software engineers? Okay. So, will that person be able to carry this forward? I had personally promised Nandan that we will make sure that it will work. They are currently using it, as I said, using an external device.
Yes.
We are very keen to use it. I wanted a more clearer recommendation from you regarding both the focal requirement as well as the camera resolution. So let me ask the question other way around. Are you sure that using those additional lenses that have not been now been obtained, the present resolution of the Aakash camera will be adequate?
I think it would be adequate that VGX camera should work.
Think is a problem. Yeah, that's why we are in engineering. You have to demonstrate whatever.
Not experiment.
Now, what is the camera with which you have successfully got a good image even without extraordinary focusing?
It's a Nokia 5530 3.2 megapixel camera. Sorry?
What is the camera specifically?
3.2 megapixel.
3.2 megapixel?
Yes, sir.
That's a lot of pixels.
Yes, sir.
That cost may be equal to the cost of the Aakash tablet itself.
Sir, more than that. Yeah,
you were supposed to build an affordable solution.
That's where the part of the lenses, the work of the lenses comes in place, no?
We can regard this as a lot of preliminary things have been achieved.
Yes.
The dimensions of the attachment, etc. have been fixed.
Yes. The only part that is left is the work with the optical. Optics.
Through the optics.
Yes, sir.
So, Nagesh, will you please take help of Professor Prakash Reddy and take this forward? So, what is the time limit for you? This guy did it in 2 months, 8 weeks, 1.5 months. You will be responsible personally, 1.5 months. So that is 15th August then, slightly less than 1.5 months. I would like to publicly announce on the Independence Day that affordable solution exists for Aadhar Authentication. Sure? Don't ditch Independence Day.
Which
What has been the cost of the components for the attachment?
The current assembly which we have designed is costing something like ₹180.
180.
Yes.
But with those additional lenses.
With those additional lenses, the lenses we ordered with the whole component, we had to order a camera itself to get the lens out. The camera was 600 cost. So you can say building those simple lenses would take at the max 200 lens. Manufacturer of the lens would take ₹200. So it would be 380 or 400 something. That would be 10 times less than what
200,
is present.
300, 400 are three figures each in increasing position.
No, currently it's 200. Adding the cost of lens, that is 200, it would be 380. Approximately 380.
400. 380. I had suggested that it should be within between 250 to 400. You think it is possible?
Yes, it might. It is possible.
There might be. There are a lot of doubts, as you can see. But this is natural. Let me tell you, the task given to them was not an easy one. They had to actually study basic optics, which all of you would have studied at some time or the other, but I am sure, like them, you would have forgotten most of it. What is total internal reflection? What is refraction? All of you are very clear on those concepts. Meaning you all remember the words. Yeah, not good enough. So, thank you very much. Let's give them a big hand. I would like to take a 2-minute break to introduce two very important people. One of them is my colleague, whom you might have seen, or have you ever made your appearance here? So, Professor Kannan Moudgalya, who is actually the coordinator of all national mission projects here. He is single-handedly responsible for convincing me to take up the Aakash project when there were some problems. And of course, for the Talk to a Teacher program was conceived jointly by us, under which we train a large number of teachers. Both these projects are considered fairly successful projects. And that is the reason why I am given a free hand to get good students from all over the country to work like this. The other person who is actually almost the atma of the Aakash project and the national mission. There are actually two atmas. One of them is not here. That person is Mr. Sinha, who was the then joint secretary. He is now secretary of the Bihar state government. He dreamt of both the mission and the project. And the person who has worked shoulder to shoulder with him right from the inception of the mission and right from the inception of all these projects is Professor Pradeep Verma. So apart from handling these projects nationally, he also works as our direct advisor. And very fortunately, whenever I request him to come over here and advise us and examine things, he has always been coming. So thank you, Professor Verma. Thank you, Professor Kannan.